All right, what's going on, dudes, and welcome to the Captain's Log. Stardate's August 11th, 2012. Lots of people wanted me to say that. I am Captain Jean-Luc Picard, and welcome aboard the Starship Enterprise. This room is apparently my Enterprise. We'll go with that. A lot of people actually seem to think that the mob spawner in the Skyblock series looks a lot like the Enterprise as well. I guess it's because of how symmetrical I made it, and the fact that it's sort of kind of circular. I don't even know, but I got a lot of comments saying that, so apparently it resembles it enough to merit several people recognizing the similarities, so we'll go with that. Sorry that we're a little late here. It's still Saturday for me today, but I'm sure for many people watching this, it might not be Saturday. It might be Sunday for you. I was out and about earlier eating things like maple bacon biscuits. I kid you not, I have a maple bacon that's like a tongue twist. Maple bacon maple bacon biscuit sitting in my tummy right now. It's kind of weighing me down. I had some very heavy food, if that makes any sense. If heavy is a possible way to describe food, I had some very heavy food for brunch. It was delicious, but it's food you can really feel afterwards, if that makes any sense. I'm sure maybe for a few people, other people just think, what are you talking about? Anyway, what I wanted to do is I was searching for a bathrobe that I used to have because I thought it would be really humorous, albeit weird, to have sort of a bathrobe, you know, with the V-neck sort of crossing over, and then some sort of wooden tobacco pipe as well as some sort of like white and blue hat with an anchor embroidered on it. I'm weird, I know, but I thought it would sort of fit the mood of the Captain's Log. Maybe I'll go thrift store shopping next week, and next time you see me, I will come back in that outfit. Yeah, I'm kind of weird. I'm sorry, that's an interesting idea. I might go for it, though. Who knows? My bathrobe that I used to have, that thing was super comfortable. I don't know if I lost it or just got rid of it, I can't remember. Anyway, rest in peace, bathrobe, wherever you are right now. Anyway. Some updates on some things talked about last week. So as far as the DeviantArt, fan art. I said DeviantArt because I was going to start talking about DeviantArt. The way I decided to sort of handle when people send in some artwork and stuff, which I should mention, I've gotten quite a bit, and there's some freaking awesome stuff in there. So thank you so much. It makes my day when I see those drawings and Photoshop amazingnesses that some of you have put together. They're really sweet. So what I've been doing is I type in Captain Sparkles on DeviantArt, and what happens is it'll show all of the images that have been uploaded that have Captain Sparkles in the title. So that's what I've been doing, and tons have turned up. There were actually a bunch that were there even before I had made any mention of fan art of any kind. And so what I did is I made a DeviantArt account. And I'll actually link that in the description, because what I do is when I search and I see something that catches my eye, I'll favorite it. Just like you can favorite a video on YouTube, you can favorite an image on DeviantArt, and that'll show up in a list that I can keep track of on my profile. And you can also see as well if you go on and go to my profile. So if you're interested in seeing any of the art thus far, you can find it there. And I mean, yeah, thank you so much. I will definitely be printing some out, and I'll probably put them just like on the wall right there, and I don't know, wherever in this room, because this is sort of like the office, and so it seems kind of appropriate, as well as, oh yeah, did I ever mention this? I don't think I did, but YouTube is giving away these reward kind of things. It's the first time they've ever done anything like this, but what they're doing is they're giving away these reward/incentives, I don't know what you'd call them, but for people who reach certain amounts of subscribers. So what they're starting off with is a 100,000 subscriber tier and a 1,000,000 subscriber tier. These were announced like a little over a month ago at VidCon. So for 100,000 subscribers, any account that has that or above, they get a $500 gift card to, it's B&H Photo Video, I think, if I'm not mistaken, which is, that's freaking crazy. There are like 1,500 channels that have that many subscribers, so YouTube bought $500 gift cards for all of them. It's like $500,000. Calculation was probably terrible. It's like $750,000 in gift cards. That's crazy. Probably pennies for them, but you know, in most people's perspectives, that's dropping a lot of cash right there. And then for the million subscriber tier, which I happen to be a part of, which is freaking sweet. What they're doing is they're giving these like golden play button plaques. So it's a plaque that says congratulations or something, and then on it there is this golden, it's like a, apparently it's dinner plate size that I've heard from people who've seen it in person, and it's, I'll make sure to show it to you when I get it. And I actually, they allowed you to submit an Illustrator file as well, so they can engrave the logo on there. I'm like, oh my god, this is freaking awesome. So yeah, I'll show that to you when I get it, as well as I'm sure everyone else will too, but you know, it's awesome. So yeah, thanks again for everyone out there allowing that to happen by watching my videos and enjoying them. So anywho, yeah, that was a totally random tangent just spurred on by DeviantArt somehow and hanging things on walls. But yeah, anyway, back on to DeviantArt again, and I don't know why I keep saying DeviantArt, FanArt, I keep mentioning, anyway. thank you again to everyone who has done that, and anyone who in the future might make another image, and yeah, so far, pretty awesome stuff. Alright, well, let's see, I think, I can't remember if MindCon 2012 location date was announced before I recorded last week's vlog. I think it was, but I just didn't mention it for whatever reason. So MindCon's actually going to be in Disneyland Paris this year. For anyone who hasn't heard that yet, I'm sure a lot of people have heard it. I'd like to go. I'd certainly plan on going. I just have to get my passport renewed, which I've been procrastinating. Again, aren't I really good at this? You see a trend. I am a professional crastinator. That's the best way to phrase it right there. I'm really good at doing it. But I'm gonna have to get on that stat, because it's end of November, same as last year, so basically a year after the first one, and I'm probably gonna need to pick up a bit of French, because from what I've learned talking to everyone is that it's good to speak somewhat the native language. Well, that's kind of a given, but the way it works, people have told me in a place like France, is that you will attempt to speak French to someone, and it's the act that counts. And then what happens is that 99% of people will simply turn around and start speaking to you in perfect English, but it's the fact that you tried that matters. So you try speaking French, and then they'll just reply to you in English. So that's the purpose. I don't know any French except for merci and s'il vous plaît, and I'm saying it in a terrible American accent. But that's the best that I can really do. And bonjour. God damn it. I'm so bad at this. I'm going to sound pathetic. Anyway. Yeah, we'll see. I don't know. I've never actually... So the crazy thing is I've never been off of North America. I've gone to... the fullest extent of my travels are Vancouver, Canada, and Cancun, Mexico. The rest has been completely within the United States. So I am a landlubber. I've been to Hawaii, though. I've been to Hawaii, which, obviously, that's still the United States, but that's... it's far away, and it could very well be just its own sort of thing. It simply happens to be a U.S. territory, but it's... you know, it's far enough away from the U.S. that when you're there, it feels like you're just somewhere else completely different, except for the fact that everyone speaks English, and so there's that. But anyway, yeah, certainly hope to go to that, depending upon how quick my passport turnover is and how much longer I decide to procrastinate. And hopefully, I doubt that I will see as many of you there as I did at MindCon in Las Vegas, because I would expect that the majority of my audience, well, I actually know for a fact that the majority is US-based, but I don't know. There were people who came from Australia to MindCon Las Vegas last year, so there may be people making the trek from the US over there, or over there for other reasons, and simply stopping by because the times coincided. Yeah, all right. Well, I think that's all I had to talk about. So anyway, that's going to do it for this Captain's Log of August 11th. This has been Captain Jean-Luc Picard. Thanks for watching. and I'm gonna go and eat some food because apparently I haven't had enough maple bacon biscuits today. So on that note, I will see you all next time.